guys, it's me, Robin, RsIslandCrafts. This is Talk to Me Tuesday for Tuesday, October 24th, 2017. This is 1 week where I actually remember the date because as I'm filming this on Monday, the 23rd, this is hubby and I's wedding anniversary. We have been married now for 21 years, been together for 27. That's a lot of years. All right, been a little bit slow in the craft room this week. As we all know, this time of the year seems to just zoom right on by us, and it's no different for me. These last couple of weeks have just flown right by. Seems like I just get one Talk to Me Tuesday filmed, and then I look at the calendar or the clock or whatever, and next thing I know, it's already the weekend. It's ready to start looking forward to doing another one. I did get a little bit accomplished this week, though. This week was the week of towels. I was decorating kitchen towels. Some nice little turkeys. Unfortunately, I chopped off all the turkeys' heads. This one's going to my kids. They're going to be having Thanksgiving at their house for the first time this year. Turkeys don't need heads, right, on Thanksgiving? I did a little sew along with me video this week on how to do kitchen towels, so I went a little bit crazy. Here's a nice pumpkin one. I also knocked out a little Christmas gift for my 18-year-old. I had used the plaid from his shirts, sewn it onto that calculator tape like I showed in a previous video. I even added this little strip of the binding on the top and bottom from the binding on his quilt. Will he notice that Mama made one that matches his quilt? I doubt it. Even hubby got some towels. In our recliners, we like to put these kitchen towels on the arms, so when you're putting your arm down and sweaty hot Florida sun, or he likes to rub his hands on them when his hands itch and stuff, so to keep the chairs clean, we put little kitchen towels on it. Now I'd made him little mini quilts for the Giants fabric, his favorite football team, but let me see, they're probably a good 8 years old now, so they were pretty worn out from being washed all the time, so I decided, you're getting towels. Plus the towels grip on the whatever the material is that the couches are made out of, the chairs are made out of, it's about the same material and it just sticks. So, but what I did for him is I put a strip of Giants fabric on the top on the front, and then so he can take them and rotate them and flip them, I put it on the opposite end on the top. So let me see. So like, this is one's right here. And then you can see how it's on the opposite end. There you go. See? He got two of them. He's a happy camper. Totally honest with you. Shh, don't tell him, but I totally forgot it was our anniversary, so happy anniversary! I remembered and made you something. Yay! Shh, secret. Do I have plans for this week for sewing? Mm-hmm. I've got a couple more ideas for towels I'm gonna sew. Beyond that, nope. Getting towards the end of October, so I feel like it starts to become crunch time for anyone who makes handmade gifts for the holidays. So I'm starting to gear up towards that mode, think of, you know, who can get what and what I need to get and things like that. The only thing else I worked on this week was, well, I guess it's a little craft related. My two oldest children both work at Tijuana Flats restaurants. My oldest boy, Justin, he asked me to come over and help him reupholster some of the chairs from the restaurant. Okay, I've done a little bit of reupholstering on seat chairs, so it's not too difficult. It's really simple. You just take the seat cover out, you take the seat cushion out there, and then you just take the old stuff off, put new stuff on. Let me pop up a picture of the 7 we got done yesterday. Yep, by the 7th one, not only were we masters, but we were really tired of reupholstering chairs. Taught my kids well, though. He went to Joann's bargain hunting. He found This is similar to color. It's not quite the same vinyl as they have in the restaurant, but when they mix them all up, they've got like 120 chairs. So when they mix them all up throughout, no one will notice them. Plus, you're sitting on them. But he found a vinyl that closely matches. He got it. It was on the clearance section with the little red tag. And then he had a coupon because, you know, Mama teaches him well. He had a 20% off, including sale items. And then, you know, Joann's, if you buy it and there's so much left after the yards, you get that at an extra discount. So he got like 5 3/4 yards for very little money. I think he said it was under $20, which is, I think, is pretty good. I think the biggest problem we had, though, is I forgot to take a picture of it, but the people who did it, I'm assuming it's a professional company, they must have put like 100 staples to hold that little seat cover in. So the first one we did, he got a little tool, so I'm sitting there and I'm popping all the staples out one by one by one while he's off getting everything ready, and no, we didn't do that. For the other six, we just cut all around the staples, cut the old vinyl off, flipped the wood base over so that the staples were against the cushion, and then just recovered it with the new vinyl. Nobody will know. Oh, that's it for me this week. I hope you guys all do something crafty. Bye!